You know, not everything that we shoot here has to be a show-stopping award winner like Matt's wagon. Nor does it have to be a multiple thousands of horsepower street-legal drag car like this T-Bucket. And it doesn't even have to be a tire-shredding, maniacal beast like this pickup. Sometimes it's okay to just have a beater. And when you go to a car show and there's a sea of shiny paint and beautiful trim and bumpers, for me, it's very refreshing to see a car that's being used as God intended it, for the wheels to be driven off of it. And that's what we're showing you today with our 65 Galaxie that we lovingly refer to as Uncle Buck. When the Galaxie came out, the Galaxie 500 came out, I should say, it was named after a couple of things that were most important to America. And in the 50s and 60s, of course, that was the space race, anything to do with space, and NASCAR. That's how we get the name Galaxie and 500 combined. Now you can see this is a fine example covered from the factory in springtime yellow. Also in gold. And there's a fun story about why this car has these colors that I'll get into in just a minute. But first I want to point out the wheels, which I feel really make this car. These wheels came off of a vintage Shelby race car, and I think they really complement the natural patina that this car has acquired in the years of its existence. In 65, Ford marketed this vehicle as being quieter, smoother, more luxurious, and more comfortable than even the Rolls-Royce. And that's, at least one of those things is true with this example. As you can see here, we've got our rich Corinthian vinyl seats that are just weathered to perfection like a fine wine. And these are covered by hand-sewn seat covers that obviously came from material from only the finest curtains at a Motel 6. Now in the 60s and 70s, the very pinnacle of opulence and luxury was gold shag carpet. Now if you had this in your house, it was something to be beholden. But to have it in your car was a rare exception, and that's part of the beauty of Uncle Buck here. Now you've got plenty of room inside and a little bit of room for passengers in the back and a comfortable ride. Even this one rides smoothly and beautifully. Now don't let the flawless paint job on this car deceive you into thinking that it could be hiding rust or Bondo underneath. The car is actually exceptionally straight and rust-free. And I don't really know what else to say. Okay. The trunk floor on this car is actually amazing. I got my key right here. Let me show you. Now, as you can see here inside the trunk, we've got a... Oh, no, I better not. Check out the trailer hitch. You can tow just about anything you want. In fact, that leads to the interesting story of how this car got the beautiful palette that it wears today. So I actually got this car from the original owner's son, who was a Ford mechanic up in the Bay Area. And a couple of years after he bought the car, he used to tow his boat and go to the lake and fish and drink beer. And I guess he forgot to strap the boat down on the way home one day. Somebody pulled out in front of him. He had to panic stop, and the boat came off the trailer with the prop striking the deck lid, twisted and went over the roof and landed on the front clip. And so donor parts were found from a vehicle in a wrecking yard for the trunk and the front sheet metal. And that just kind of, the story kind of adds to the charm of this paint job for me. And it's part of the reason that I don't believe I will ever repaint the car, but I've had it for maybe 5 or 6 years now, and I am kind of hungry for a few changes. And I'd like your help. Tell me, what do you envision for this car? I think maybe do the interior, maybe put a big honking motor in it or something. Let us know in the comments what you would do with this car if you had it. Now back here, you can see, again, we've got a really straight quarter panel with just another touch of color to add to the palette. And we've got this great patina. And this top is actually functional and it's in mint condition. Let me show you. Um, You know, I just remembered another great story of actually when I bought the car, and I'll tell you about that in just a minute. It's kind of an experience of all the cars I bought over the years. I've never had the experience that I had when I bought this one here in particular. And as you can see, the top works beautifully, and it is in mint condition. And it's actually such a cinch to put the top down. You know what? These cars are meant to be driven with the top down. So let's put it back. Now, it's a fun story also about how I acquired this car. It popped up in my neighborhood and I just had to have it, but I didn't have enough money. But I caught the owner at the right time one evening when he was, say, a little bit more than slightly inebriated. And I made an offer and he said, okay, go get the money. So I went and I got the money and I came back. He counted it out and he said, no, this is too much. I said, no, that's the amount we agreed on. And he said, no, it's too much. And this is kind of an intimidating guy, and I don't get intimidated easily, to be honest with you. But he slapped me in the face and stuffed $200 in my pocket. And I was just so confused that I didn't know how to react because he was being so nice, but also he just slapped me in the face. So I took the money and ran. What would you do? We still have the original 352 under here. It's not much to look at, so I'll spare you popping the hood. But the thing that I really wish you guys could do, because it's the best thing about this car, is driving it. Since you're not able to drive it, why don't you hop in and ride shotgun with me? We'll go take a lap in it. Now, when you drive the car, the oil light, the red oil light here, continues to flash or stay on for lengths of time, which initially I thought it might be something complicated like the sending unit, but after more thought, I think it probably just doesn't have oil. So it's a simple problem.
Let's hit the road.
I know the question that's on all of your dirty little minds. Will the old Galaxie do a burnout? Well, to be honest with you, I don't know. I've been driving this car forever and I've never even tried. I kind of suspect maybe not, because it's a 352 and that's probably one of the most powerful boat anchors ever built. But let's give it a shot, huh? This is for you guys. Having a show car is pretty neat, but life is neater when you drive a beater. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay tuned for next week, and don't forget to subscribe to the Garage Box.